I, Joseph Robinette Biden Jr., do solemnly swear.
So help you God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. President.
Well, America, meet your new first family. The Bidens are walking into the house now, the White House, where the President and First Lady will make their new home. And for anybody out there wondering, yes, there has been a deep clean of the building, given the fact that the previous occupants did not take coronavirus particularly seriously.
World War III, okay? It is World War III, but we have a sacred obligation. Just understand, and don't kid yourself, no matter what you all say. Let's get it straight here, guys. Where we were a year ago, the direction we're headed in, World War III.
Vaccinated America, go and get the vaccination.
I should be prosecuted.
Do you know, we don't rule out first use nuclear.
Conditions are so bad that one woman who News Nation has been in contact with has rashes on her body after showering.
We're going to be with you, Mr. President, for as long as it takes.
We'll do it.
Thank you.
How does this whole experience feel for you?
That money matters more than humanity.
World War III has never been closer than it is right now. We need to clean house of all of the warmongers and America Last globalists and the deep state, the Pentagon, the State Department, and the national security industrial complex. One of the reasons I was the only president in generations who didn't start a war is that I was the only president who rejected the catastrophic advice of many of Washington's generals, bureaucrats, and the so-called diplomats who only know how to get us into conflict, but they don't know how to get us out. For decades, we've had the very same people, such as Victoria Nuland and many others just like her, obsessed with pushing Ukraine toward NATO, not to mention the State Department support for uprisings in Ukraine. These people have been seeking confrontation for a long time, much like the case in Iraq and other parts of the world, and now we're teetering on the brink of World War III. And a lot of people don't see it, but I see it, and I've been right about a lot of things. They all say Trump's been right about everything. None of this excuses in any way the outrageous and horrible invasion of Ukraine 1 year ago, which would have never happened if I was your president, not even a little chance. But it does mean that here in America, we need to get rid of the corrupt globalist establishment that has botched every major foreign policy decision for decades, and that includes President Biden, whose own people said he's never made a good decision when it comes to looking at other countries and looking at wars. We have to replace them with people who support American interests. Over our 4 years in the White House, we made incredible progress in putting the America Last contingent aside, and bringing the world to peace. And now we're going to complete the mission. The State Department, Pentagon, and National Security Establishment will be a very different place by the end of my administration. In fact, just into my administration, it'll be a very different place, and it'll get things done, just like I did 4 years ago. We never had it so good. We'll also stop the lobbyists and the big defense contractors from going in and pushing our senior military and national security officials toward conflict, only to reward them when they retire with lucrative jobs, getting paid millions and millions of dollars. Take a look at the globalist warmonger donors backing our opponents. That's because they're candidates of war. I am the president who delivers peace, and it's peace through strength. There was a reason we had no conflict. There was a reason we didn't get into wars, because other countries respected us. I entirely built, all right from the beginning, rebuilt our military. It's a big reason for that. They didn't want to mess around with the United States, and now they're laughing at us. We could end the Ukraine conflict in 24 hours with the right leadership. At the end of my next 4 years, the warmongers and frauds and failures of the senior ranks of our government will all be gone, and we will have a new group of competent national security officials who believe in defending America's vital interests above all else. Thank you very much.
Tuesday, 21 February, in the year of our Lord, 2023. Write this one down in your book, because now it's evident to everybody that we are into the early days of World War III, as the kinetic part, as we've talked about for a long time here. And I can't think of a better juxtaposition of Max Evans over there at Getter, that magnificent video. Essentially, the storm is here. The storm's not coming. The storm's not on the horizon. This is not a gathering storm. This is a storm that's here, okay? And President Donald J. Trump, in just over 3 minutes, is there a more succinct summary of where we are? Also, folks got to understand, if you think this is going to be easy in this primary, if you think it's going to be easy in a general election, if you think the second term of Trump's going to be easy, and everybody says, oh, he says mean things, everything, hey, grow up, okay? We're in it now. We're in it now. And as imperfect as he is, that's exactly the guy this country needs right now. And if you don't think all the forces arrayed against him are not going to come to stop him and stop what he stands for, you're kidding yourself. I'm going to get Michael Patrick Leahy and Jeff Clarker to join me in a second, and you can see exactly what they're like. If it was not for Donald Trump announcing he was going to East Palestine, Ohio, these gutless cowards would have just kicked the people to the curb like trash. When he announced it and initiated this on Friday, the whole thing changed. Now they're all up there. They're going house to house. You know, they're on the sofas. They're taking guys' temperatures. Is everything okay? Can I get you a Coke from the refrigerator? Screw you. Your phoniness, just because you're popping out there before Trump, he forced the action, because he's a forcing function. He's a forcing function. He's like something out of nature. This is why they hate him. They hate him because they hate you. They hate you. Let me repeat this. Did I say it? They hate you, okay? And he's the armor-piercing shell, and they know that. Boris Epstein, that was 3 minutes of just succinct, to put it where you consider the babble that Biden's in. We're going to play it later. Biden's in Warsaw, and he's tripling down on Kamala Harris. He called Putin and these guys war criminals and crimes against humanity. Note to self, even if you believe that, okay, if you believe that, the way things roll, right, the way things roll, the way that Abraham Lincoln ran it and the way that FDR ran it is, let's win first. Let's win first, and then we can try them, okay? If you believe that, win it first, because otherwise they're just going to dig in. And Zelensky's now Biden's over there. It's unlimited, got unlimited time, unlimited thing. Zelensky's, and they're saying that Zelensky's going to say, I'm going to take them, my tanks are going to be in Red Square. And then somebody, you know, rational came up and said, no, we just want all the territory back, including Crimea. We want to pay trillions of dollars of reparations, and we want Trump's war criminals. Okay, I got it. That's negotiation. That's your opening bid. It's a little aggressive, but it's an opening bid. Boris Epstein, we're in it right now. Donald J. Trump understands that. That's why it's a tale of two cities. It's Ukraine and East Palestine, Ohio. Give me your assessment, sir.
Steve, honored to be with you. Honored to be with the posse today. Never been a starker contrast between President Trump standing up for America, standing up for Americans, fighting for every American as he goes to visit East Palestine tomorrow, and Joe Biden, who's taking 20-hour train rides to Kiev to participate more in the war porn that's been being pushed on the American people. This is absolutely disgusting what is happening. And Steve, I'll say it again now. We're in the one-year anniversary, right about the beginning of the invasion of Ukraine by Vladimir Putin. I said it was a mistake by Putin then, and I will say it again now. It was and continues to be a major mistake by Putin to take that action and invade Ukraine, full stop. It is also a catastrophic mistake by the American quote-unquote leaders who are illegitimate, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, to be sending billions and billions and billions and billions of American dollars, American weaponry, and let's be honest, those American quote-unquote instructors, we have boots on the ground in the Ukraine right now. And Joe Biden on President's Day, instead of supporting America, instead of going to East Palestine, instead of supporting Americans, where is he? He's in Kiev with Zelensky. I'm not going to say that Zelensky's got something on Biden, but it's pretty interesting. With all that Burisma information, with a Hunter Biden laptop from hell, why is Joe Biden just so dead set on being buddy-buddy with Zelensky? Something is off. And again, this war should have never happened. It needs to be put to an end. It needs to stop. And America is doing right now, under failed leadership of hopeless, pathetic Joe Biden, America is doing nothing but making it worse by feeding into the conflict, by funding the conflict. What needs to happen is a solution has got to be figured out, and we have to stop this fire that's festering around a cluster of nuclear reactors in Eastern Europe. And again, to anybody who needs to figure out why this has to end, all I want to do is point you to 1913 in Eastern Europe, the beginning of World War I, then point you to the 1930s and 40s in Eastern Europe, World War II, and the fact that the bloodiest, most destructive wars in world history have been fought on the very soil that this war is happening in right now, and it's got to be put to an end. Otherwise, as President Trump said, we're at the precipice of World War III.
Biden was there today in Warsaw, Sarajevo and Warsaw, the two big conflicts of the 20th century that kind of all merged into one, of which the United States bailed everybody out. Hadn't been for our troops in 1918, nobody in 17 and 18, no end of war. Unbelievable. Boris, I'm going to ask you to hang on a second, because you bring up something very important, and I can't figure it out. You know, Biden, they're talking about when Biden, you know, with the classified documents, one of the things his office was running around, and he took a trip to Ukraine. He went to Ukraine on like the 16th of January of 2021. What guy has got the last couple of days in the White House? What are you going to Ukraine for? This whole Ukraine thing has just never made sense to me. There's something that, and you don't want to get in conspiracy theory, but it's something just not right. It doesn't make any sense, this obsession, this maniacal obsession by our political elites that Trump called out, and he called them out by name. Victoria Nuland in this crowd. Boris Epstein's going to hang over. I've got Jeffrey Clark. I've got all kind of news out of East Palestine, including Shapiro. You think Shapiro's running scared off the war room? He sent a letter today, a criminal referral to the Attorney General of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania about Norfolk Southern. Well, the buck ain't going to stop there. There are a lot more dirty hands than just Norfolk Southerns, and theirs are pretty dirty. Sure. Despite the U.S. blowing through $31.4 trillion debt ceiling in January, the leftist White House still refuses to reduce spending. While our national leadership has buried their heads in the sand, when it comes to fiscal responsibility, it's time to pull yours out. Think about this. To dig our country out of this mountain of debt, every single taxpayer in America would have to write a check for $247,000, and it's only going to get worse. Now would be a great time to diversify into gold with Birch Gold. In times of high uncertainty and instability, gold is king because it's dependable. Birch Gold makes it easy to convert an IRA or 401k into an IRA in precious metals.
Here's what you need to do. Text Bannon, that's B-A-N-N-O-N, to 989898 to claim your free info kit on gold, and then talk to one of our precious metals specialists. Protect yourself with gold today by texting Bannon to 989898. That's Bannon, B-A-N-N-O-M, to 989898. With an A-plus rating, with the Better Business Bureau, thousands of happy customers, and countless five-star reviews, you can trust Birch Gold to protect your future. Text Bannon to 989898 today to get your free info kit. Take action. Use your agency.
Here's your host, Stephen K. Bannon.
Danger than it's ever been in because of a word known as nuclear. Nuclear is so devastating that we don't even want to talk about it. And that was a word that was never supposed to be mentioned. You have two N-words, neither of which should ever be mentioned. I said that once. I said, oh, what a terrible thing to say. No. You have two N-words. You know what the one is, but the other is the nuclear word. Not supposed to ever be mentioned. Ever. It's mentioned every single day now. Every single day they talk about, will this end up in nuclear war? We're on the precipice of a disaster, the likes of which this world has never seen. This will make World War I and World War II like baby stuff.
That guy right there kept the world at peace. Look at the gangsters. Look at the guys in Tehran. Look at the mullahs and the ayatollahs. Okay? You see the demonstration with the kids and what they're doing with the girls? Look at that. Look at those pieces of work in Saudi Arabia. Look at Erdogan in Turkey. Look at the crowd you got in Syria. Look at Pakistan. Look at the Chinese Communist Party in Beijing, and look at the KGB FSB in Moscow. And let's throw in Mini-Me there in North Korea. That is the greatest collection of bad guys in world's history. And hey, I'll throw in Lula down in Brazil, and maybe there's a couple other three that we don't have right now, right? These are not just bad hombres. They come with big countries with lots of resources. And they're not the friend of the Judeo-Christian West. They're just not. Our values are not their values. And right now, that guy, President Trump, and I don't care, oh, he says bad things. He tweets out bad things. He calls people nicknames. I don't care. I do not care. It's not important. It's not relevant.